Okay, hello guys, welcome back to the channel. Today we're going to go over our latest severe weather season predictions for the upcoming spring. And so we're seeing a pretty good chance that significant severe weather could occur across some of the Midwest and parts of the South and even to the Gulf Coast. Now before we do get started here, I'd like to make sure you subscribe to the channel today and like all my videos and including this one for more weather-related content. Now we're going to start off with this month, where a good portion of the Southeast could be seeing severe weather this month, including the major cities of Houston, Atlanta, and Tampa. There could be severe weather later on in the month, as there are a few models indicating that there could be ingredients there for some severe weather, and this could be increasing likely as more models continue to depict that this could happen. The central U.S. and parts of the Mid-Atlantic could see severe weather next month. And as far north as Rapid City, this could be the case. Major cities include Denver, Kansas City, Nashville, and also Indianapolis and Cincinnati and Columbus. Areas in the Midwestern parts of the Northeast and the rest of Mid-Atlantic, and as well as portions of the West, could be seeing severe weather in April. This could also extend all the way to the Canadian border for this early. Major cities include Denver, Sioux Falls, Chicago, Cleveland, Washington, D.C., and New York City. Much of the rest of the U.S. could see severe weather May or later here in the year, including Phoenix, Salt Lake City, Minneapolis, Boston, and as well as even some in the Rockies, such as Boise, and even as far as Los Angeles, too. Now, this graphic includes the highest possible risk the Storm Prediction Center could give for any area of the United States. We're going to start off with the high risk in the central U.S. and includes Mississippi and Bermuda coast to southern Minnesota and western Wisconsin. There is a high potential that severe storms will occur in the spring in this area, but this could also be the highest potential or severe risk from the SPC or Storm Prediction Center at any given time of the spring. Now the next risk, which also encloses the high risk area, is the moderate risk, which extends into the Southeast and also into the plains and also goes to the Canadian border in some spots. The moderate risk includes more major cities such as Nashville, Oklahoma City, Sioux Falls, Minneapolis, Chicago, and Milwaukee. There is a moderate or likely risk that there will be severe thunderstorms sometime this spring and may fit with what the month that severe storms could also start occurring across this region. Now the third risk, which encloses the two regions we just went over, is the enhanced risk, which means that there is a very possible risk of severe storms anytime this spring, which includes the major cities of Atlanta, Cleveland, Washington, D.C., and Tampa, and as well as Houston. And then the slight risk, which encloses the three regions we went over, means that there is a possible risk of severe storms any time given of the year. In the western part of this, there will likely be hailstorms, or any hail events, basically, so severe storms are likely to occur in some of these spots, which means there could have been a later warranting to high risk, such as enhanced. That would be also Denver area and also major cities like El Paso and Brownsville. And then also New York City and Boston, the other side, which can see some possible severe weather, won't be as likely as the central U.S. Now the final region, which also encloses four regions, has a separate area, is a marginal risk. Phoenix and Salt Lake City are close to this region, but not quite in it. But Portland, Maine could also be in this marginal risk. Another area along the California coast includes major Californian cities such as the Bay Area, which includes San Francisco, San Diego, and also Los Angeles. and it also extends to Eureka, California area. Looking ahead, there could be severe weather events in the end of February and beginning of March. Starting with this one on the 28th of February during the PM hours. That could include the southeast and the Gulf Coast. You can see the instability map, which extends not very far inland, but still a threat for severe weather appears to be possible in the southeast and the Gulf Coast. The bulk shear also appears to be favorable for the severe weather conditions, and so you might need to watch out for that because there could be severe weather on this day, and even though it's like several days out, it can still happen anyway. Now to the March 1st event, which includes the southeast and the Atlantic coast to the Virginias. There is going to be plenty of instability available for this kind of severe weather event. And not only that, but there also appears to be enough wind shear for this. And so this is really important because the bulk shear could be really strong. And so this is really something that is really potent. And now we go to the dew point maps for both events. And if you can tell that there are dew points in the 60s for the regions that may be impacted by severe weather, which is very favorable. And also as well as the March 1st event that is potent, but we still have plenty of capability for this happening, especially with the March event. But models are expected to change, and so we'll forecast because this is about a week out from now. Alright, that is it for today, guys. Make sure you subscribe to the channel, like my videos for more weather content. Bye-bye.